Hotspot analysis is a key tool that finds significant spatial clusters of high values and low values, helping you identify and measure the strength of spatial patterns. With ArcGIS Pro 3.1, you can now compare two hotspot analysis result layers to find their similarity and association. It's about to get hot in here. From the Vancouver Police Department website, I downloaded the crime locations for all of 2022 and added the points into ArcGIS Pro. From here, I created a hexagon tessellation and aggregated the point data to generate a count of crimes inside each cell. To calculate statistically significant clusters of crimes, I will open the geoprocessing pane, and inside the Spatial Statistics toolbox, I can find the Hotspot Analysis GI Star tool. For the parameters, I will use hexabins as the input layer and the count as the input field. I'll accept the other parameters and run the tool. The resulting analysis shows crime hotspots centered around the downtown core, along with two other hotspots further away. For comparison purposes, I also performed the same analysis with crime data from 2012. As I drag the two maps side by side, you can definitely notice the similarities and the differences between the two hotspot result layers. I would love to be able to visualize and quantify these differences. So here we go. I added the two hotspot result layers into a new map. Let's return to the geoprocessing pane to find the new hotspot analysis comparison tool. Just enter the two layers as the parameters and run the tool. When the tool is complete, three layers will be added to a group layer in the map. The first layer measures similarity, how closely the hotspots spatially align. The lower the similarity, the darker the color. The second, spatial fuzzy kappa layer, indicates association, measuring the strength of the underlying statistical relationship between the hotspot variables. The third layer displays significance level combinations, showing pairs of scenarios. The dark red cells, for example, show new hotspot areas over the 10-year period, while the hatched red cells show areas that are no longer hotspots.